Back to 2050. It sounds like, really getting close to end of the world, for humanity. And I'm not really enjoying where I live right now, my location in life, my location on this planet. Like, was this the best choice? It's kind of a freak out location, because there you are, desert, higher propensity for that 140 in the summers, and then the build up to the 140, because it won't just be 140, you'll have the months that are 120 and then the months that are 110, so it's going to be like a real, where was winter? Eventually, winter is just going to be either. We could have it just flip-flop, it just seems like it's such an Armageddon situation, the movies, it's bringing up all these weird movies, us all living in our houses, raising our own food to survive, and meanwhile there's something called property tax. I mean, that has to be abolished. There is no way this is going to work. Property tax. When human beings have to raise food in their own houses? No. That's going to have to go away. I just see absolute lots and lots of just secessions happening over here, over there. Lots of, some will be military fascists groups, and others will just be no gun groups. Yeah, a lot of that happening. It's gonna get, I mean, the government never helped, and all the government knows how to do is put people in camps. It's not an answer. Anyway, I'm kind of upset, because I didn't want to really live in that movie, that futuristic movie where everything's become so grunge and, it's just about survival and struggle and the, oh, an orange. Oh my God, how'd you get an orange? That is so neat, because yeah, there won't be planes flying in, because their engines will be overheating. We're not going to have food flown in. We're not going to have anything fossil fuel motored. Even electric, that'll be too sketchy on grid supply. Is the grid going to be up enough at that heat to give it out? And it's not just the give out for that one vehicle or whatever. It's going to be the blowout of the grids because of air conditioning, and people won't change that habit. They won't change their habits. And so the grids are just going to keep blowing. And so food supplies are going to be disrupted. Anyway. And then so then we're going to end up looking at how do I raise food right in my house, because it's too scorching outside. And then a property bill will show up, in the how dare you category. The government will still try to exist. So the only way is to really is to say that's it. I'm no longer a part of the United States. That's the only way. They won't stop. They're a wheel that just keeps rolling. They're never going to stop their act. You know, we can all be you know, water up to here, no house, just treading water, in as Florida just sunk, and no, no, all it's going to be is there's a camp over there. If you can get out of the water in time, because they only have one helicopter in that area, because they have so many other helicopters that they need in other areas. So it's going to be a pretty bad, even rescue situation. Just like those movies, they used to have these movies back in the 70s and 80s. That the whole world, just the big calamity. You know, here comes the tidal wave. Yeah, that type of movie will happen. But for real, you know, we'll be living in it. And then the government said, well, what do we care? We have the tunnel. Remember that movie had the tunnel, and they had all the food in the tunnel. They stored it all away. A bunch of idiots. They weren't ever going to have fresh again. They were just going to store it away in a tunnel. And then only certain people got to drive into the tunnel to live. Yeah. So that's the government plan, and that's never going to change. They still have their specific people that are saved, and the other ones are going to be, it's too late. You know, we made our decisions, and we're locking the door, we're locking the key on all of them. You know, it's up to them to have their anarchy, their militias, their... We can't even cope with it any longer. Yeah, it's gonna be absolute hell. So I guess all I can say is in an oddness, you know, as the years go on and the years go on, and if nothing changes, if we don't have some major coup of planet, hey, it's saved. If that doesn't happen, we're going to be just, who are your buddies? Who are your pals? Do you have, you know, a good group? It's going to start looking like that. And because there is going to be no protection for any of us on a single level, a couple level, a family level, that's not going to ever be enough protection. So I know I'm like, oh, like militia, yuck. But unfortunately, gated community, all of that has to occur. And if that gated community is smart enough to say, hey, over there, that one raises lemons or lemons and oranges, and that one over there just raises Basil, well, then that's fine. And if you have 20, 30 houses and you all share the food supply within, well, then that's okay. That's not the American way, though. It's not the way people have been trained. People don't want to share. People don't want to even know their neighbor. We've all been brought up differently. We don't tolerate each other well. It's not a conversation you want with everyone. So in a way, if you did not get in that neighborhood where you're all possibly buddies at least, or at least can have conversation with, then you're going to be in a problem. So yeah, it's going to go down to that. Like if the neighborhoods themselves are group oriented to make, you know, massive control state change of their environment so they survive. So it's not anarchy. And it's not just like running down to the community shop for help, you know. It's going to literally be the onus on each and every person living in that community, like a giant co-op. Anyway, and the refugees will pour in little by little, you know, another refugee here and there. Can we take more into our community? Can we take more into our community? And it's going to be all these small little questions that have been going on and on are going to happen in small little communities. So it's going to take the big discussion that was up to the United States or was up to France or was up to these big countries to decide. And it's going to be now down to little tiny provincial mindsets. So it's not going to be a good situation. I mean, you can hunker down and say, well, I'll just live on my own, and if somebody approaches, I'll shoot. You can pull that, but you have to have a lot of space food, like you have to have all of your, did you buy that, you know, like 50 years ago? Because when that time frame happens, you're going to have supplies for years and years and years to make it on your own. And it's going to have to be things like all of the dried beets or the dried, the mâchés, all of that. You're going to have so much of that to survive. That's just not an answer. It's not an answer, is it? You know, that single seclusion, family set, person set, that's just not the answer. You know, each one living on their own little island within the house, house to house to house to house. But yet, you know, people are very non-acclimated to community. All you can do is hope that your group is semi-tolerable and not perverted for the women, and have some kind of, you know, maybe take a house and make one house in the community actually a community center, where food has to go and be stored, you know, where it becomes the local shop, because transportation from former times will not exist. You're not going to have that privilege. You're not going to have that privilege when you have 140 degrees. I mean, and I don't think 28 years is enough to turn us into the frigid rocket that can just go house to house and house and drop off food. I don't think that's going to happen. We have little freezer rocket cars. I mean, 28 years. Look back. That was in the 1980s. And it's the same traffic commute. Nothing has changed since then. So it's going to be a barbaric situation. And meanwhile, the U.S. government is still going to be asking for property tax and income tax, because it's a wheel that will not stop rolling. I don't know how we can personally secede. Just say, I'm no longer a U.S. citizen, right here in my house. I don't want anything to do with you any longer. But we're going to have to create that as an answer, because there is no way that we can have that many people living in camps, living in tents, dying intense. Preparedness. You know, it's going to all be about preparedness. I'm going to sign off on this one while Florida is sinking.